Poisonings are the leading cause of unintentional injury death in the United States. This is largely driven by prescription medications and especially prescription pain medications. My name is Barbara Inslee Crouch, and I was a co-investigator in this ARC-funded study, and I am the executive director of the Utah Poison Control Center. Poison centers are a 24-hour resource for poison information, clinical toxicology consultation, and poison prevention education. And they're staffed with pharmacists, nurses, in some cases physicians or physicians' assistants. And their role is to assess the situation over the telephone, take a thorough poisoning history, and make a risk assessment on whether the situation is safe to manage on site or whether or not that patient needs to be referred to the emergency department.
I'm Dr. Mollie Cummins. I'm an associate professor of nursing and an adjunct associate professor of biomedical informatics at the University of Utah. I'm the principal investigator of this ARC-funded study. Currently, U.S. poison control centers rely upon telephone communication to share information and collaborate in the context of poison exposures. The purpose of our study was to determine the information requirements for a health information exchange-supported collaboration process between emergency departments and poison centers. There's a lot of essential information that's being shared between the emergency department and the poison center that does not require telephone communication. And we want to transmit that information electronically. We also want to institute closed loop communications where the poison center can verify that the emergency department has seen a communication and vice versa. One key challenge in health information exchange is information overload. We have to deliver select subsets of highly relevant health information at the point of decision making. You have to make the information move and you have to make it matter. If you're in the emergency department and you're in the middle of taking care of a patient and the poison center calls, you make a choice: stop taking care of the patient to pick up the phone, or don't take the poison center call. And we don't think healthcare providers should have to make that choice to get the information that they need.
My name is Todd Allen. I'm an emergency physician at Intermountain Medical Center at Intermountain Healthcare in Salt Lake City, Utah. The busy workflow of an emergency department is one of the biggest challenges to effective communication with the poison control center. It's the interruptions, it's the pace that make this so difficult. It's what calls for a real-time and standardized way to communicate about these cases.
This study revealed clear inefficiencies and safety vulnerabilities in the current process. Some examples of what we found were the discussion of multiple cases within a single telephone call and difficulty in discerning one patient from another.
The key safety vulnerabilities included ambiguous exchange of clinical information, as well as the exchange of information with non-clinical care providers in the emergency department. In the current process, information is being documented in disparate data sets. The poison center specialist is creating a medical record at the poison center, and then the emergency department has a record on that patient that is solely within that hospital system.
Using health information exchange, we can create a process where the emergency department care provider does not need to be interrupted from their workflow in order to access key information to take care of a patient. We think that care can be improved by sending more accurate and complete information automatically so that the poison control center can update their recommendations in a more timely way.
We're not going to eliminate the need to talk to a clinician about a difficult or unusual problem and provide an explanation about a recommendation. It's just going to streamline care by allowing the poison center specialist to get online and see the change in status, and that will then prompt them to make changes in treatment.
Health information exchange to really improve patient care is the holy grail of the electronic medical record. The continuity that's enabled by this type of technology will be quite profound.
We sought additional funding from ARC to develop, implement, and evaluate a health information exchange supported collaboration process. The idea is to create a replicable, scalable process, a process that could be adopted by any emergency department and poison center in the United States. What we're proposing is a much more dynamic form of health information exchange, where we're delivering the right information to the right person at the point of decision making. This project has the potential to fundamentally change the paradigm for communication and collaboration between emergency departments and poison control centers.